It all started when Nicholas Murphy, this skinny skeleton stoner of a 17-year-old who was maybe the best person I'd ever known, hopped in his dad's black Honda Civic, sped onto Highway 10, and drove himself all the way to heaven. But the funny thing was, 4 hours before the crash, 4 hours before Nick was just strawberry jello on asphalt, it was the second Sunday in summer, and everything was still normal. Nick and I sprawled across my bedroom carpet, watching a drunk moon stumble between the slots in my blinds. I smoked a twiggy pinky finger of a joint and talked, roundabout snakes of sentences that coiled into themselves, beginnings twisting into endings. Nick only got high when he was sad, so he just sat and ate sandwiches that he made by squishing thumbs of stale Nutella between two Ritz crackers. At something like 3 in the morning, I lost myself halfway through some thought, something about Doritos and breakfast. So I stopped talking, and I looked at Nick's plain face. "What?" he huffed. "Finally tired of the sound of your own voice?" Nick was the kind of kid who should have been someone else, someone better, and maybe, if he lived somewhere, anywhere, other than Katy, Texas, he would have been. But instead, he lived here. Here, with me and Katy, this sweet, sugar cookie suburb of Houston, where everyone's houses looked so similar that you forgot which one was your own. The only things to do in Katy were get high in someone's bedroom, or join the basketball team, the Raptors, or go to the Star Mall. But Nick got winded walking up half a flight of stairs, and his die-hard Catholic parents taught him to feel guilty for buying himself anything that costs more than a soft pretzel. So, most days, Nick, who was too smart and too good for me, really, somehow ended up in my room, breathing in the smoke from my joint, looking down at his faded jeans, and wondering, half resigned and half disgusted, why he was even there in the first place. Thank you.